All right, how's everybody doing? We're gonna follow up on the camshaft on this motor we're building, the bus motor. We have our case in the stand now. We got it all cleaned up. We got a fresh line board here. We have all our dowel pins reinstalled. We have the cam bearings on this side of the case fitted. We're gonna run a double thrust bearing on this setup. That means it'll have two thrust bearings in the front instead of just one half like they normally come. If you're going to run extra spring pressure or an aftermarket camshaft, it's a good idea to get a thrust bearing set with two thrust bearings in it. They'll ask you if you want a single or a double thrust bearing, and you want a double if you're going to run heavy spring pressure. So when we put the cam bearings in, it doesn't matter what manufacturer you try to use nowadays, the cam will be tight and more than likely won't turn properly. It will not spin freely. You need about probably 4 to 5 thousandths in play on this camshaft so the gear can swell up. You got an aluminum gear on the cam and a steel gear on the crankshaft. So you want a little bit of expansion room. You don't want to tighten this down so tight. What happens when everything gets hot, it pinches that bearing and it'll burn the thrust surface right off the bearing. The other thing that you want to look at if you're running a high performance cam is you want to check the clearance between the lifter and the lobe. When the lobe's pointing all the way down at the lifter, you want to have at least, a lot of people say 50 to 60, I like about 75 to 100. When you start running really aggressive camshafts, this clearance will get harder and harder to obtain. A lot of guys will machine the lifter surface down a little bit, and that's the way you get the area if you're running a super high lift cam. This is 385 at the cam, I believe, this cam. So we got some feeler gauges there. I've got 100 and I'm happy with that. So that's one of the measurements you need to check. The other one is the thrust. You want to have some thrust movement there and you want the cam to spin really nice. I got this case half over here set up and I'll show you what I'm talking about, how tight the bearing will actually be when you put it in there. So anyway, try to do this without blocking the camera. This is a cam bearing that we've fitted, and this is the thrust surface. This is the thrust surface on the bearing, and this is what rides against the thrust surface on the cam. And this is the area that you're gonna have to clearance to get the proper thrust on the camshaft. Like I said, this one's already been done. This one has not been done. It's just like it comes out of the box. This is a Coleman Schmidt bearing. And these are some of my least favorites. I like the silver line. That's this would be a yellow box like so. That's the triangle part number. Silver line, it's not hard to remember. That's about the best quality you can get nowadays. So anyway, this is an aluminum construction bearing and the ones we're using in this are steel. So this one's super tight, I already know that. I put it in out of the box and I'll show you what happens. You put this in there and install it. You get the camshaft, you saw how the cam turned in this half after we prepped the bearing. I don't like to put any oil on there, you shouldn't need the oil on the bearings for setup. Now you can already tell that this bearing is super tight, it doesn't want to push in, and you actually have to push the cam into the thrust bearing. This probably will just turn the bearing in the journal. There's no tang on one side. There's a tang on one side. There's no tang on the other. The bearing locks against the bearing with the tang. When we try to turn this cam, it's going to grab the bearing and bring the bearing out of the journal is more than likely what's going to happen. It's turning, but it's very tight. And then there goes the bearing out of the journal like I thought would happen. So what's happened is the bearing is actually pinched on the surface of the camshaft there in between the two surfaces of the thrust surfaces there. The cam bearings are actually too wide from the factory. You can see that bearing says standard on it and there's the Coleman Schmidt part number. So let me show you how you fix this. Like I said, it doesn't matter what bearing you buy, you're gonna run into this issue for some reason. It never used to be this way, but it is now. So we're gonna take that bearing off. And a piece of glass is the preferred way to do this. If you have a piece of glass, that's the catch meow. My table's pretty flat. I'm not worried about this. This is just for illustration purposes. I won't use this aluminum bearing. So anyway, let me get you on the bench here. We'll just put a piece of sandpaper down. All you do is, if you had a piece of glass, you can use a piece of 180, piece of 400, something like that, you know. This is 320. We're just gonna sand the thrust surface. You're gonna have to sand it quite a bit too. You're gonna be like, wow, is there gonna be any bearing left? I had people ask me that, and there's usually enough bearing left. You wanna do both sides? Don't just do one side. Try to keep the amount symmetrical from one side to the other. Of course, there's no way you can measure the bearing before you start this with some calipers. Like I said, you want about 4 thousandths, 5 thousandths, depending on how much spring you're gonna run. Get a paper towel. I don't wanna get my motor dirty here. We'll go back to the case halves. And we'll give it a try. If the camshaft's not rotating when you're building a motor, this is almost always the issue. Still tight. That gives you an idea of how tight it actually was. So, way too much material, and there's really not enough space to take the amount off that you need to take off. That's why a lot of guys freak out when they have to sand the bearing like this. That'll even, usually start with a more aggressive piece. Just because I know that it takes a lot to get this off, and some brands more than others. We'll hit this with some roughy and then go back to smooth it out. Do this with some safety clean or some water. Piece of glass works best than a piece of bigger sandpaper, you know. Just giving you an idea of how much it takes to make the bearing fit. There's no way possible you can take it out of the box and make it work. Some guys think that it'll break in, but it won't break in. It'll just burn the thrust off the bearing. And these aluminum bearings, what they do is they weld themselves to the camshaft, because aluminum melts fairly low temperature. There's a lot of friction there when it's really tight. So we just now got it to turn. You can see we're heading the right direction. And I'm not gonna go any further with that bearing. You guys get the idea of what you need to do. There's the bearing that's been properly fitted. It's like one of those cooking shows. We already have one in the oven. Let me set the cam down and slide this in. Little tap, the old, silver lines fit much more precise. And that's how it should turn. Nice and free, not trying to snag any of the bearings, and should be able to hear it. You know, if you put a gauge on there, it's probably gonna be right around 4 or 5, if I had to guess. But it needs to turn freely like that. And that about covers the cam. We talked about how to install the gear, dot up, lobe down, and 18 foot-pounds. Use Loctite on the bolts, and then you have to fit your cam bearings. And that's where we're at with this bad boy. Next, we're going to start assembling the case. The case here, we use a split bearing setup in the front, so we're gonna have a steel bearing here, and should be a little more beefy. So yeah, that's another Volkswagen video there for you. A little bit on setting the thrust on the cam.